morning with the sunrise in my eyes. Just like a new day, a breath of fresh air in my life. I don't know how and don't know why, but
privilege to welcome you here this afternoon to the church here for a very special occasion where Daniel and Nicole were about to make their very special promises to each other. I welcome you as the family and friends, particularly to acknowledge the non-Catholic family and friends who join us on occasions like this, and I hope you feel very welcome in amongst us. Also to acknowledge those of us who've travelled interstate to make the numbers up to help with a good occasion, so the gift that is given as well. If I can just also acknowledge the stole that I'm wearing, the religious stole, is a gift from the Aboriginal community in Stradbroke Island, given to me for my 40 years as a priest. So I always want to wear it on special occasions, and for me, this is a very special occasion. So without making Nicole and Daniel any more nervous, we might begin with the opening prayer. Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord. In your kindness, bless Nicole and Daniel. As they stand together now before you, may their love for each other be strengthened. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. I'm going to invite Beck, Daniel's sister, to lead us in the first prayer. And the reading is from what they call the Song of Songs, which is originally a love poem written about the 2500 BC, then taken over by the church in relation to God's love for the church. But today, returning to be a love poem from a husband to a wife.
Show me your face, let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet and your face is beautiful. My beloved is mine and I am his. Set me like a seal on your heart, like a seal on your arm, for love is strong as death. The word of the Lord. Response. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. They are happy whose God is the Lord, the people he had chosen as his own. The Lord looks on those who revere him, on those who hope in his love. Response. Our soul is waiting for the Lord. The Lord is our help and our shield. In him do our hearts find joy. We trust in his holy name. Response. May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place our hope in you. Response.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I am going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but I am without love, it will do me no good whatsoever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense, and it is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. The word of the Lord.
And our final reading for today is from the Gospel of John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father had loved me, so have I loved you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments of love, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments of love and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my own joy may be in you and your joy be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you." And this is the gospel of the Lord.
This afternoon, I don't want to keep you long, but just think it's important that we, for a few moments, think of the significance of what's happening here this afternoon. I think the promise that Daniel and Nicole are about to make to each other is the most wonderful promise one person can make to another. It's the most powerful sentence that one person can say to another. I will love you and honour you all the days of my life. So it's a real privilege to be here with Daniel and Nicole as they make these wonderful promises to each other. We all know from within our own family and friends the enormous pressures on marriage today. So it makes these promises even more significant. It's my experience at weddings at about this stage, people are starting to move into the mode of being in an audience. Look around the church and see how nice this is done. I've seen what a beautiful bride Nicole has made. You're probably surprised how well Daniel has scrubbed up after his much party. But if you think you are an audience, then Nicole and Danny will trick you. Because you are not an audience, you are participants in their promises. If fact that Nicole and Daniel will make their promises in your presence makes you participants in their promise on behalf of the wider community that you represent. You have probably added your gifts to the wishing well. If I said wishing well, I should have seen gleaming and magnified. But I believe that the best gift you can give is your love and support to them in the years ahead of their marriage. And I believe that if you do make that promise to them, then they can make their promises to each other with enormous confidence. After all, you are the people that they wanted to be with them on this special day. Interesting quirk in the English language, the more often you use the word in different contexts, the less clear the word becomes. Love is one such word. It is used on TV programs such as Love at First Sight or in some of the songs of Ed Sheeran, but very different meanings. But love is used in this ceremony today, and that's why that second reading that Sarah read, particularly that second paragraph, is so often used in wedding ceremonies. Because it gives a definition of love, which, as Daniel and Nicole are about to say to each other. And if we use that definition, then it becomes a very powerful word, because it includes all the qualities in that second paragraph. Love is always patient, kind, ready to excuse, to trust, to hope. Love does not come to an end. Let us define and include all these qualities. It becomes a very powerful and significant word. So when Nicole and Dan will say to each other today, I will love you, it is a magnificent promise. And finally, it's significant that Daniel and Nicole are making their promises in a church. I've tried over my 50 years as a priest to teach people about a God of love. And I believe that that God of love makes himself vulnerable to human love. Because I don't think we can appreciate God's love for us unless we've been loved at a human level first. And so human love, Nicole and Daniel's love, can be a mirror of God's love, and hence the value of their promises being made in the church today. So I'm now going to invite them to step forward to make those promises to
So I've invited them to make their promises to each other. So Nicole and Daniel, have you come here readily, without coercion and freely, to make these promises to each other?
I have.
Are you prepared to live in marriage, to love and honour each other for as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his people?
I will.
Since it is your intention now to enter into marriage, join your hands and declare your assent before God and these people. So, I, Daniel.
Take you, Nicole.
To be my wife. I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honour you
all the days of my life.
Well done. You'll be changed. Nicole.
I, Nicole.
Take you, Daniel.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honour you
all the days of my life.
Excellent. May God strengthen your consent that you publicly made today. May God bless you to bring this fulfillment within you throughout your life. We've now come to the blessing of the wedding rings. The wedding rings with the circle, symbolic of, we pray, of Daniel and Nicole's unending love for each other. So Lord, bless these rings which we're about to give to each other. May they be a sign for them of their love and trust throughout their lives. We ask this blessing through Christ our Lord. Can you take
it?
Nicole, take this ring
as a sign
of my love
and my trust. In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
Okay,
Nicole. Daniel, take this ring.
Daniel, take this ring.
As a sign.
As a sign.
Of my love.
And my trust.
And my trust.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Well done.
We come now to the wedding candle and the lighting of that, and the symbolism involved, that the fathers will light the candle, representing their care for their Nicole and Daniel, and then they hand the lit candle to Irma and to Anne as the mothers who cared for Daniel and Nicole. And the candle now represents their single life, in which their parents have cared and looked after them. And I'm going to invite them now to give their candle to Daniel and Nicole. And the large candle on the altar represents their married life together.
Sorry.
It's not a competition, Anne.
So they'll light the candle that represents their married life together and their care for each other into the future, and blow out the candle that represents their single life. And the next prayers are going to be led to us by the two grandmothers, so if I can invite Edna in to come up. My dear brothers and sisters, as we call to mind the gift of love and faith by which God has blessed the love of Nicole and Daniel, we now entrust these prayers to our loving God.
For Nicole and Daniel, our newly married couple, may their future together be blessed with enduring love, peace and joy. Let us pray to the Lord. For Nicole and Daniel's parents, Anne and Stephen, Irma and Reuben, may they be blessed for the gift of their faith, their loving support, and their gentle presence in the lives of their children. Let us pray to the Lord. For all members of our families who have passed from this world, for Nicole's grandparents, Michael, Norman, and Alma, for Daniel's grandparents, Fernando, Paula, and Tony, may we continue to treasure the gift of their love and example in our lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
If I can invite our Daniel's grandmother, Mary, to come forward.
For Nicole and Daniel's families and friends, may you continue to bless their life with your love and friendship. Let us pray to the Lord. For all families throughout the world and for lasting peace among all people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, in our midst, send your love and concern for Nicole and Daniel. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. If I can invite you to pray with me together the prayer that Jesus gave his disciples, a prayer that acknowledges God as a loving parent, and so we can pray for a wonderful life ahead for Nicole and Daniel. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. We come now to the key blessing prayer of the ceremony, so I can invite you to stand to witness that blessing prayer. Let us pray for the Lord for Nicole and Daniel, who today begin their married life. May they always be bound together by love for one another. God our Father, maker of the whole world, you created man and woman in your own likeness and will that their union should be crowned with your blessing. We pray for Nicole and Daniel, who are joined together in the marriage covenant. May your abundant blessings come upon Nicole and Daniel. May the power of the Holy Spirit be with them, so that living out together the gift of marriage, they be known for their integrity of their conduct. In happiness may they praise you, in sorrow may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their work, and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. And after a happy old age together with the circle of their friends that surround them, may they come to your kingdom in heaven. May God, the all-powerful Father, grant you joy. May Jesus Christ, the Son of God, stand by you in kindness, in good times and in bad. May the Holy Spirit of God always pour forth into your hearts. May this blessing come upon you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I invite you to sit down. That's God on me.
That's it.
Nicole and Daniel have signed in writing, verbally their promises. I'm now going to invite them to come forward to sign in writing the promises, and invite the bridal party to come forward to be witnesses to that.
Thank you.
privilege to announce Nicole and Daniel fully married. I'm going to ask Daniel to do that very difficult task of kissing the beautiful bride. They ask you to stand and greet the newly married couple.
Times roll. One knee, one ring, just like a new day, a breath of fresh air in my life. I don't know how and don't know why, but I'll be toasting all my life.
Everyone can just be seated now. Thank you. Thank you, Tim. Hello. It's now time for the formal part of the evening. We will have some speeches. I can imagine that today my father Stefan is feeling extremely proud of Nicole and the magnificent woman she has become. Unlike my wedding day, where the emotion of Dad would have been one of relief, tonight it's obvious that both Mum and Dad are elated. I'm sure you're all very curious about how such a cynical, stubborn and unromantic man is going to deliver a Father of the Bride speech. However, if there's anyone that can melt Dad's heart, it would be Nicole. So please, let's give a warm welcome to my dad, Stefan.
Charming, thanks, John. Always been my favourite. Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to this wonderful celebration of love and commitment between two very special people. Anne and I were delighted this afternoon to witness the marriage of Nicole and Daniel, and we're really delighted to be here tonight to celebrate in the company of so many family and friends. So thank you so much for joining us. This marriage has been a long time in the making. Nicole and Daniel's relationship goes back over 9 years, back to when they actually worked at the Target and they used to wear those cute red and black uniforms. Their first real commitment started 3 years ago when they purchased their apartment in Bellevue Hill. And I sort of figure that if their relationship can withstand the pressure of paying off a Sydney mortgage, then married life will be an absolute breeze. I felt very privileged this afternoon to be able to escort my beautiful daughter down the aisle and present her to her future husband, who I know will love her and care for her Now, it's very emotional being father of the bride, despite what John says. And what amazed me was how composed and beautiful Nicole was. And I sort of figured, if she's not going to cry, I can't cry. But I can tell you it was pretty difficult. It was very special today to have Anne's cousin Frank presiding over the service. Frank married Anne and me almost 35 years ago, and he's been very much a big part of our family over that time. Frank has the ability to make a service very personal and meaningful, and I really thank him for making the day so special. Of course, the real benefit of having a relative to the service is you do get a discounted rate. At least that's what I'm hoping, Frank. For us, Nicole has been the perfect child. Certainly compared to her siblings, who were way more challenging. The only issue I had with Nicole growing up was that she was very untidy and her bedroom was always a mess. Nicole would emerge from her bedroom looking immaculately groomed, not a hair out of place, and she would leave behind a trail of destruction. It's interesting to note that since moving in with Daniel, her tidiness has improved remarkably. So, well done, Daniel. Nicole started life being somewhat sort of quiet and shy, possibly being overshadowed by her older brother, who could be quite loud and sometimes obnoxious. But, you know, she soon overcame that, and she readily embraced her numerous sporting activities, her school activities, and her university studies with a real passion and commitment, always showing a fierce determination to do her very best. She was a quiet achiever, never seeking attention or recognition, and those qualities very much remain today. Your mum and I are so very proud of the confident, mature and thoughtful woman that you have become. For me, the biggest compliment I can pay you is to say that you are very much like your mother. Oh, wait, it gets better. Elegant and stylish, gentle and unassuming, you are sensitive to the needs of others and respond to people with compassion and understanding. You very much recognise the importance of family, and you're extremely loyal and supportive of your siblings, your extended family, and your Nana, who you have a special bond. Daniel could not have asked for a more loving or caring partner. Tonight, I can formally welcome Daniel into our family, recognising, of course, that he's been very much part of our family for many years. I sometimes think those early years may have been a bit tricky for Daniel, given that my family can be very loud, opinionated, and overbearing, very different to what I am. But I think it helped that he was a good sport and he has a good sense of humour. That certainly helped. But from early on, I thought Daniel seemed the perfect boyfriend. Tall, handsome, well-mannered, witty. He reminded me very much of myself. How could Nicole, you know, refuse that? We did also notice that Daniel was a good cook and he enjoyed fine food. And that used to make Anne very nervous when he came for dinner. Anne now accepts that Daniel's a better cook. So she just puts him to good use in the kitchen whenever we have people over. Daniel is a talented, confident, and ambitious young man. I very much admire his hard work ethic, whether that involves long hours in the office or doing manual work around his apartment. He has a kind, considerate nature, and he's always willing to help out wherever he can. He too values the importance of family and has a very close relationship with his sisters and parents. Daniel himself comes from a very loving and supportive family who we've come to know over the last few years. Being of South American extraction, they are very passionate and affectionate people. And as you can see tonight, they're very good dancers. I'm still getting used to all the hugging and kissing that goes on. And that's just from Ruben. But Anne and I certainly enjoy their company, and we look forward to the bonds between our family growing even closer over time. Nicole and Daniel are a loving and supportive couple who have laid the foundations of a long-lasting relationship. The qualities and values that they share, their happy and positive outlook on life, and the respect that they have for each other, I think will help ensure they have a very successful life together. Your mum and I congratulate you on your marriage and wish you every happiness for the future. Be assured you will always have our love and support throughout your married life, and that does include limited babysitting duties. Not that we're in any hurry. Please join me in congratulating Nicole and Daniel.
Thank you, Stefan. Now, rightly so, as Stefan pointed out, we may not actually get to hear Ruben speak tonight because by the time he finishes getting around the room hugging and kissing everyone, his time might be up. It seems that Daniel has inherited some great qualities from Ruben, including his warm nature, his infectious laugh, his full head of hair. Sorry, Daniel. Nana Prasala agrees and often tells us she can see where Daniel gets his good looks from. Without further ado, please welcome the father of the groom, Ruben.
Well, good evening, everyone. For those that I haven't met just yet, I am Daniel's father, just in case.
I am your father, Daniel.
Irma and I would like to welcome everyone to this very special celebration of Daniel and Nicole's wedding. It's been, like Stefan said, a long time coming. But if I can start first by saying that, Nicole, you look absolutely great. You look absolutely radiant and gorgeous as always. Daniel, you're a very handsome man. I would like to take this opportunity to also congratulate the bridal party, because I think the bridesmaids have looked beautiful today. Yeah. And the groomsmen don't look that bad at all. Daniel, when you were born, your mum and I were over the moon because we felt that our family was complete. We had two beautiful and wonderful daughters, and now we had you. People used to tell us that we would get a huge surprise when we had a boy, and that our life will be turned upside down. But the harsh reality was that Daniel was a very good baby, and even in his growing years, as a teenager, Daniel was a very kind and considerate person. Now, let me put this on because the light is not that good in here. As a toddler, Daniel was easily pleased. All we needed to do really is to give him a set of keys, and he was as happy as Larry. So much so that his grandmother went about collecting keys to make up a key ring so that, and disinfected every single key obviously, so that when we came to visit him or visit her, you know, he would have some to play and he'll be sitting there happily going with a bunch of keys. It's a shame that Nicole, you know, things are not the same these days, and not just a couple of keys is what makes him happy. Daniel has been a very well-behaved son that grew up with two older sisters, and in our opinion, that's what made Daniel very balanced and certainly very caring, but more importantly, a very integral part of our family. Daniel has been a person that, you know, he likes and he shows his affection. He is, he shares, he likes to share a good laugh. He enjoys family life, and whilst he has strong opinions, he also does hear to other people's opinions. And yeah, this is a very important part of his growing up. As a teenager, Daniel was very thoughtful. He would help Mum to unload the groceries from the car when she came home every afternoon or whenever she went shopping. On a almost daily basis, he would ring Mum at work and ask her if she wanted us, or well, if she wanted Daniel to start dinner for the night, for all of us. This is something that, as he grew older, and whilst he lived at home, he continued to do. So, you know, very, very happy that that was the case. Not that my wife is an awful cook, because it's not meaning that at all. Because she's a very nice and very able cook. But we've actually watched Daniel mature over the years into a very thoughtful man. And he has grown like a fragrant flower. In bloom as the years whiz by. So, and the years have whizzed by pretty quickly. Daniel, your mum and I stand here in front of you today, the proudest parents that ever lived, because of the man you are, or the man you have become. And because you are the fulfillment of our dreams for you. Daniel and I, just in case nobody knows, share a love of cars that come second to none. And I soon realised that Daniel had a very strong love outside of that, when one day the car that he loved so much was sacrificed for a life together. This car had been his pride and joy for many years, and even after a few minor absent-minded incidents, you know, the car was sold. So Daniel decided to sell his pride and joy for a financial gain, and bought one that still doesn't like driving. However, the good point about that process was that Nicole was able to drive it too. And she also let go of her pride and joy as well. So Daniel and Nicole met in high school, and they were partners for the year 10 formal. And they began dating after high school, and have grown together into a beautiful couple that you see before you, culminating in their wedding today. Nicole has always, in our eyes, been very loyal, fun-loving, family-proud girl that shows a lot of maturity in everything she does. We have loved you, Nicole, from day one. Now, this is where the South American thing takes over. And, I'll try to hold back the emotions, but Nicole, if there was ever one person in the world that we would have chosen for him, it would have been you. And you only. Thank you. We are blessed that you are now part of our family, and we know you're going to be an amazing wife to Daniel. Daniel and Nicole have embarked in a life or in a journey living together when, as Stefan mentioned, purchased their first apartment 3 years ago, and have continued to grow into a very sensible, compassionate, responsible, maybe when it doesn't come to drinks, sincere, focused, and loving couple that bring the best out of each other. I feel very happy to see their relationship culminate in their wedding vows to each other today, and who knows what the future may bring. Not that we're in a hurry, but anyway. Irma and I would like to thank Stefan and Anne from the bottom of our hearts for bringing up such a loving and adorable daughter in Nicole. Also for your patience, over 9 years, perseverance, accepting and taking Daniel into your family, even before today. Big thanks also to Frank, our priest today and always. A big thank you also to Edna, Miriam, Sarah, and Rebecca for their respective beautiful readings today. Our niece, Jessica, the makeup artist. Yeah. And obviously our nephew, Paul, the official photographer for today. Thank you also go to John and Mel for your MC duties tonight. And also, yes please. And also to all the people assisting and lending long hours of your time to make this wedding day a huge success. As a parting thought for Daniel and Nicole, I would like to add, your marriage, like all others, will have its share of ups and downs, of conflicts and frustrations, and hopefully not too much boredom. But what I want you to bear in mind is that we don't marry the person we can live with. Rather, we marry the person we can't live without. As you may know, the smartest investor that ever lived will tell you that all kind of investment options can be very risky. But That is not the case when you decide to invest in loving each other till the end of time. Sorry. So my advice to you both is to tell each other of your love daily. Respect and show understanding to each other. Never go to sleep angry at each other, and be prepared for lots of compromising. Not that you don't know that already, but yeah. So Daniel and Nicole, we love you till the end of time, and we certainly want you to know that we will always be there for you. From all of us, we wish you a long and happy life together.
I'd now like to invite someone very special to our family, my mother's cousin Madeline, to say grace.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. As we begin this meal with grace, we bring with us all the prayers and blessings of love and trust for the future that we have prayed today for Nicole and Daniel. Before God, we come with love and gratitude to their parents, Anne and Stefan, Reuben and Irma, and their families for gathering us today, and we acknowledge the thoughtfulness and creativity of so many who have ensured that we will enjoy this happy meal together. In the 2000s, there was a French children's story that became a great favourite, and the central character was an outgoing and very brave little character named Madeline. I would like to finish with Madeline's grace. We love our bread, we love our butter, but most of all, we love each other. Amen.
Thank you. Emma has always been the best sister to Nicole. Whether that be stealing her clothes, using her makeup, or simply just getting in Nicole's way, Emma really has been the perfect little sister. Emma has been looking forward to this day where she could stand beside Nicole as her maid of honour. I'm sure one day, maybe in 2041, Nicole will have the same privilege. Please welcome our younger sister, Emma.
Thanks, John, and I really do hope it's before 2041. Before I commence, I just want to give a quick shout out to the groomsmen, who deserve a bit of love too. You're looking sharp tonight, boys, and Matt, I'm really glad you shaved that beard off. There's not too many stories I can tell where Nicole has completely embarrassed herself. Apart from that infamous time, she went a bit too hard, too early, and Mum and Dad had to pick her up well before midnight on New Year's Eve. Her friends may say otherwise, but to me, Nicole is just like our mother. Beautiful, kind, caring, elegant, selfless, and very much unlike her siblings, extremely humble. As my older sister, Nicole has taught me many things in life. John has pointed out a few. But tonight, I really want to share with you three of those lessons. Firstly, whilst determination, routine, and resilience is key to achieving your goals, being modest goes a long way. Growing up, Nicole was extremely studious and athletic. She always had her head down, working towards her HSE or a high jump competition. As an adult, she moved on to her CA, working long hours at Target and beginning her career as an auditor. Not sure why she did that, but yeah. Sorry. Whilst John and I would moan and groan, often letting stress get the best of us, Nicole would always just get on with it. Even breaking her arm days before the State Athletics Championships didn't deter her from competing, complete with a bright pink cast. Nicole was the sister who let me sleep in her bed when I couldn't sleep before my HSE exams, who calmed me down when I was hysterical after missing a 1 meter high jump bar at my first high school athletics carnival, who let me hold one of her many, many, many trophies to take a photo for Mum when we were little so it looked like I was a winner too, and who has always had my back when I've needed her the most. Nicole has always been an exemplary role model for John and I. And while she has never, ever, ever boasted about her achievements, we are extremely proud of her and blessed to call her our sister. Secondly, Nicole has shown me that you deserve the absolute best in a partner. One of my first memories of Daniel was when he showed up at home with a massive bunch of flowers to ask Nicole out. Although Nana was never really sure what he was asking her out to, from that day forth, Nicole had her better half. Daniel has always been like a brother to me, telling me how it is. Emma, you've got too much fake tan on, too much makeup on, and those hair extensions are awful. Years later, I really wish I listened to his advice. Jokes aside, in Daniel, I see a man who is madly in love with my sister and who brings out the best in her. He is equally as determined as her, even if it took 10 years to propose to my sister, and goes after what he wants. Finally, Nicole and Daniel, as a couple, have always shown me that family is the most important thing in life. The love that they show for each other, as well as their families, is a testament to the type of people they are. Never holding each other back from opportunities, even if it meant Nicole spending 6 months in London whilst Daniel continued to build his career in Sydney. They are loving, kind, generous, and always looking like they've stepped off a runway in Paris. One day they will make exceptional parents, and I look forward to the many more memories ahead that we will share together. So Nicole and Daniel, I would just like to raise a toast to your love. Cheers.
Thank you, Emma, that was beautiful. Okay, Daniel and Kurt have been friends since their high school days, where I hear they both had terrible haircuts. While they seem to have sorted out their hair, they still have a lot in common. They both work in property. They are both with blonde girls. And they both love fast cars. But I hear only Kurt has managed to acquire one of those. Daniel, your time will come. Please welcome the best man, Kurt. Say a few words.
Thank you. Okay, last time I gave a speech for Daniel, it was at his 21st, and it was about his truancy behaviours. After that, Daniel's parents didn't talk to me for a couple of years. So before I get started, Mr. and Mrs. Gonzalez, last few years have been great. Today's been lovely. But I can't wait to talk to you all about today in a few years. So, firstly, as the first non-family member to get up tonight, which is lovely, I'd like to thank the Prisalo and Gonzalez families for bringing everyone together tonight and today. It's, yeah, absolutely lovely. Nicole, you look amazing today. You're absolutely stunning. And I'm sure after today, Daniel might finally let you graduate to buying all your own outfits. Emma and Beth, killing it as always. You two look beautiful. Dan, took a lot of work, but you scrubbed up all right, looking very sharp. Matt, love your style, great outfit, looks great. Well, I remember, Matt will be operating a complimentary trolley service at the end of the evening. Between here and the hotel, so if you need a ride, just start dancing by yourself and then lay down on the floor. Yeah, that's how you hail a ride. So, as you do with these occasions, I've been thinking back to where our friendship began. Daniel and I first got to know each other in Year 8 English class. Our first real conversation was around a car magazine. They were a thing back then. Daniel was admiring a million-dollar Mercedes, and I was saying I'd rather have a turbo Datsun. Which I think is a fair point. Looking back on that conversation, it would come to perfectly sum up our relationship. We'd always be into the same things, just Mr. Gonzalez would do it with a hell of a lot more style. 15 years later, as was previously mentioned, we'd end up at the same job, at the same company, even Daniel doing high-end apartments and me doing urban sprawl. We've been the closest of friends for that entire time, and he's always been the first person that I go to when looking for advice or when I need someone to hang out with. A few years ago, I moved down to Melbourne, and since then, every time I'm in Sydney, I go home to see my parents and I go to Dan and Nicole's in Bellevue Hill. Everything else seems to fall into an optional bucket. But as Nicole has already told me earlier today, today is not about celebrating our bromance. Sorry, I set you up, mate. So Daniel likes to tell these romantic stories about the Year 8 dance and the Year 10 formal. They may be embellished just a little bit. So let me take you back to where this all really began. To where all great relationships start. Schoolies 2006. Having so much fun. It was a year that saw the emergence of Jaeger bombs and vodka Red Bulls. It was soundtracked by Ministry of Sound, and it was thoroughly confirmed that year Daniel will put his hands up for Detroit. Loves that city. It was during this cultural pinnacle that our lovely and elegant bride and groom had their first romantic encounter on the beach at Surfers Paradise, bringing to life Stefan and Anne's worst fears about letting Nicole go to schoolies. Pashing some sketchy dude on the beach. Rumour has it they're taking a trip back up there on Sunday to recreate the magical moment. Seems a bit over the top, but hey, you only get married once, right? Dan knew he'd hit the jackpot when getting back from school. Dan knew he'd hit the jackpot when, after getting back from school, he's guess who strolls into Castle Hill Target for their first shift. That's right, it was Dan's lady in red, Nicole Prasad. It wasn't long after that he started planning these elaborate strategies to spend more and more time with Nicole without seeming like a creep. It was a bit of a surprise to find out who was behind the creation of a Target mixed netball team. My wingman duties kicked in, and in no time I'd been roped into playing wing attack. I'm sure Daniel had a vision of showing off his athletic prowess. Brave move when trying to impress a Prasalo. I think Nicole referred to his netball skills as cute. Just like a baby elephant falling over. Netball season led into end of season getaways. It was really hard work losing every game in the season. We had Daniel on our team. And then into dinner parties for Daniel to show off his culinary skills as a 20-year-old. I think he had a lot more success with this avenue. Nicole was impressed he'd mastered the dark art of turning on an oven. After a while, Dan worked out he didn't need these elaborate plans. Turns out, Nicole actually just wanted to hang out with him. Don't worry, mate, we were just as surprised as you were. Fast forward 8 years to November 2016. And Daniel was proposing to Nicole in a way only Daniel could, surprising Nicole with an outfit complete with new shoes and accessories, waiting on the bed for when Nicole got home, followed by an amazing dinner, resulting in all the guys in this room hearing the exact same phrase, "See, why can't you do that?" Thanks, Dan. Appreciate it. Which leads us to today. They say you should marry someone that complements you, that has the opposite strengths to your weaknesses, the yin to your yang, if you will. Daniel, you have managed to find a person that is intelligent, charming, funny, beautiful, patient, fiscally responsible. And Nicole, you managed to find the very raw end of that deal. In all seriousness, these two beautiful people have been a massive part of my life over the past decade. You both have come so far already, from the lay-by counter at Target to the streets of Bellevue Hill and a million places in between. You two have grown up together and shaped each other into amazing people in that time. I'm sure I speak for many people when I say that being around both of you and your relationship is an absolute privilege. Daniel, it's been an absolute honour being your best man. So on behalf of everybody in this room, I would like to say thank you for bringing out the best of each other. Thank you for years of great friendship and for allowing to celebrate you as our Gonzaleses do with a hell of a lot of style. So with that, I'll propose a toast to a lifetime of happiness, Mr. and Mrs. Gonzales. Wow.
As a big brother, you hope that your sisters will find a partner that will respect, love and care for them. Daniel, you've proven to be this person to Nicole. It's obvious that you and Nicole share a special bond and you make her extremely happy. Nicole is a confident, intelligent and kind-hearted person, and I know she's going to make a wonderful wife. And one day, you'll both make wonderful parents. Daniel, your family should be very proud of the man you have become. I am proud to call you my brother, and we all officially welcome you to the family tonight. Please welcome the groom, Daniel.
To our family, friends, distinguished guests, those of lesser distinction, and those of no distinction at all, welcome to our wedding reception. Nicole and I are humbled and honoured that so many of you have made the effort to be here today to share in our celebrations. Someone once said that a good speech has both a good beginning and a good ending, however a great speech keeps them very close together. Well, unfortunately, this speech is neither good nor great, so please make yourselves comfortable. I would like to start by thanking the numerous individuals who have helped make today the amazing day it has been so far, and the fun night yet to unfold. There's a saying that it takes a village to raise a child. I can confidently say it takes a metropolis to plan and pull off a wedding. Thank you to Frank for officiating our ceremony. For those who don't know, P.S. I'm the last one to speak, so there's a lot of doubled up ground here, but bear with me. Frank married Nicole's parents, Anne and Stefan, and a number of other people in this room. So it means a lot to us that Frank was able to marry us today. In addition, a big thanks to Madeline for all of your support in helping Nicole put together the order of service. A special thanks also goes to two of my cousins, Jess and Paul. Thank you so much for being so willing to be a part of our day. Jess for doing the girls' makeup and Paul for being our photographer. Our wedding experience has been so enriched by having so many people we love by our side every step of the way. We'll get to this, but thanks, Ruben, for the emotional gene in the family. Thank you to all of those who helped at the ceremony, Alex, Michael, and Sarah. This dark room. Oh, there you are, over the back. Thank you very much, Armady, for being our man on the ground today. You fielded a lot. You just did anything we asked for. Just thank you so much. Thank you to Mercer, our yaya in law. There she is at the back, for organising the delicious biscuits that were handed out at the church. With the help of John and Mel, but we'll give it all to Mercer. Just like the rest of the Spinos family, you have always been so warm and welcoming to Nicole and I from the first moment we met. As I said, make yourselves comfortable. And I'm so grateful that through John and Mel, we've also gained a Greek extension to the family. From the moment we started wedding planning, we had our two MCs in mind. Who better than Nicole's particularly charming and charismatic brother, and his even more charismatic, and some might say funnier, wife. A huge thank you to John and Mel for agreeing to take on the task. I think everyone will agree with me when I say you've done a phenomenal job. And a special shout out to Mel for being the fellow wog in the Prasalo family. Us wogs need to stick together. To the extremely and ludicrously talented Emma Fraser. Thank you so much for singing at our ceremony. It still boggles my mind that my colleague and friend of 4 years has such ridiculous talent that everyone in the office was oblivious to. She'd occasionally hum at her keyboard, but that was the extent of it, guys. The most humble, phenomenal woman you'll ever meet. Even in our ceremony today, sings and gets straight off. No bow, no nothing. Thank you again. Moving on to our families.
We love you, Daniel.
Thank you. While we would have loved to have had all of our grandparents here with us today, we consider ourselves extremely lucky to have two. Miriam, or Nana, or even Nonna to some strange kids in the back. Thank you for being an amazing grandma. You are part of so many of my treasured memories, many of which are centered around your incredible cooking and baking. Edna, you have played such an important part in Nicole's life, so much so that on the drive home from about every family get-together, she will point out that one day she hopes to be as fabulous as her Nana. Thank you both for your readings at the ceremony and for adding to our existing memories and creating new memories with us today. To my two sisters, Sarah and Rebecca, my favourite sisters. Thank you for all of your support and assistance and for being part of our ceremony today. Growing up, I never considered it to be the ideal situation growing up as the youngest of three children with two older sisters. Often faced with the choice of playing Ken to your Barbies or no play at all. But hey, it's made me the person I am today and I wouldn't have it any other way. This one got last added at the last minute. Thanks for always managing to steer family dinner conversations down an inevitably weird and hilarious path. And Adam too. You have, as recently as last night, proved to be remarkably capable of that. Thank you for always being there for me, and more importantly, for the way you have embraced Nicole into our family. And now on to my siblings-in-law, John and Emma. Whilst it is no shock that you two are siblings, looks aside, it is often questioned by many how you two could possibly be related to Nicole. However, to me, it is incredibly apparent, as you all share the same key qualities. An unlimited amount of love, care, and dedication for your family that knows no bounds. Something I'm truly grateful you have both extended to me over the last 9.5 years. Parents, where to begin? I would like to take this opportunity, first and foremost, to thank our parents for everything they have done to make today possible. Nicole and I have been absolutely floored by your generosity towards putting on this amazing day. And there is absolutely no way we could have done this without you. Irma and Reuben, Mum and Dad, thank you so much for always working so hard to give us more than we needed in life, and for always encouraging, some might say forcing, me to study hard despite my best efforts to focus on anything but study. Thank you for instilling in me good values and a strong work ethic very early on in life. Mum, thank you for giving me your personal strength and resilience, my passionate approach to all things in life, be they great or small, for fostering my love of cooking, and also for my innate ability to be rather direct at times. For those who know Emma, that makes a lot of sense. She's pretty direct. Dad, thanks for instilling in me my love of having a laugh. P.S. I think I'm covering everything Dad just said. My love of having a laugh, including my, some might say, distinctive laugh itself. My love of cars and wine. My thick head of hair. And most importantly, my love of a good hug. Oh. And thanks for giving me the emotional jingle. To Anne and Stephen, thank you for always being so welcoming from the very beginning. I felt like a part of the family for longer than I can even remember. And thank you for being the kind, caring mother that you are, for putting me to work in the kitchen for as long as I can remember. I look forward to many more years of trying to make sure you don't forget to serve something at dinner. Or walking into the door, or walking in the door to a tray of raw meat and a simple greeting of, "Hi Daniel, how are you? Could you deal with this, please?" Stephen, thank you for being such a generous-hearted man and for your sarcastic sense of humour. Something that took me a while to get used to. But now I think I'm pretty good at reading when you're serious or not. I think. More than anything, Anne and Stephen, I have to thank you for raising Nicole to be the amazing woman she is today. And special mention to Anne. There is no doubt that Nicole is her mother's daughter. Please, could you all raise a glass to Irma and Reuben and Anne and Stephen, to the parents. And now, our bridal party. Beck and Emma, you two look beautiful tonight. Thank you for being such a big support to Nicole on this journey, and for throwing her an amazing hen that she will never forget, despite missing the memo that the groom should not be in attendance. Beck, you and I have been friends for almost 14 years. Thank you for the fun and laughter, From the target days of messing about in lay-by to going out for many nights in the town, I look forward to many more laughs to come. Emma, it's been a privilege to watch you grow up over the years. You've come to me for advice from time to time, and sometimes you've taken it. But truth be told, you never really needed it. To my groomsmen and best man, Matt and Kurt, thank you for standing alongside me today and for always being there for me over the last 14 to 24 years. You two are looking pretty sharp tonight. Thanks for dealing with my weird dress codes. No black, belts are the enemy, and the list goes on. Belts are the enemy. Thank you for putting on an awesome Bucks party. It was a phenomenal day and night, although I hear the ride home was a bit bumpy. Matt, it's been a long time, from kindergarten through high school and then ending up at uni together. You've been a constant throughout most of my life. We have the ability to go months without seeing each other, but when we do, we pick up where we left off, and it's always fun. And I won't lie, you always bring the more intelligent conversation to the table. Kurt, where to begin? You've been the best man I could hope for, from helping put together our engagement party, to wedding planning, to Bucks party planning from Melbourne, to helping put together the day that is today. We've been friends since high school, always had a lot in common, particularly cars, and that dominates our conversation even today. Nicole, we need a new car. She promised me after the honeymoon. Witnesses. Thank you again for everything you've done to make today what it is, and for our friendship over the last 14 years. And on behalf of your mum, Nicole and I look forward to planning your wedding. Nicole, I'm still completely blown away by how beautiful you look tonight and the realization that you are now my wife, aka Mrs. G. From when we first met in year 8 through to year 10 formals to working at Target together. Notice how I skipped the schoolies part, Kurt. To now, we've been together for almost 10 years. I'm so incredibly proud. Oh my god. Proud. Proud, rather. I'm so incredibly proud of the woman I've watched you become. Everything you have achieved, and everything we have achieved together. And I'm so excited for what the future holds for us. You are caring, loving, kind and compassionate, and most of all, exude class, no matter the situation. You are the cool, calm and collected to my loud, crazy and impulsive, and I wouldn't have it any other way. You are without a doubt my best friend. I love you so much, and I look forward to spending the rest of my life with you. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in raising a glass. So close. To my stunning bride, Nicole. Thank you.
I don't know about you guys, but I love the emotional gene. I was a blubbering mess. And I pulled it together now. So, a couple of things. Firstly, I just wanted to quickly point out before I forget, those beautiful personalised red cologne bottles are not actually aftershave. Those are all, happens to be mine and Daniel's favourite cocktail, and I think Nicole now as well, Negronis. So you pour them over ice, so as much as you'd love to splash them all over yourselves tomorrow, it's an alcoholic drink. The second thing I wanted to point out before I also forget, because I'm starting to get stuck into the wine, is please hashtag all your photos Gonzo Goes Pro. So that's the hashtag for tonight. I think we're supposed to mention that right at the beginning, but it's better late than ever, right? Okay, so let me just find out where we are up to. Oh!
Bye. I now invite the bride and party to